हेलो फिजियोस, आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू अवर चैनल फिजियो विद्यापीठ। आज का जो हमारा टॉपिक है वो है बेसिस ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोथेरेपी के अंदर ट्रांसफार्मर। ठीक है, ट्रांसफार्मर जो है हमारा वो एक बेसिक इलेक्ट्रिकल इक्विपमेंट है जिसको हम बहुत अलग अलग मोडेलिटीज में वाइडली यूज करेंगे। इट हैज अ लॉट ऑफ सिग्निफिकेंस इन SWD, दैट इज द शॉर्ट वेव डायथर्मी। इन इट we have transformers and also we have capacitors in it, which is our next upcoming video. Okay, so my name is Vijay Kumar and let's start the topic. What is transformer? Transformer is an electrical equipment which work on the principle of electromagnetic induction. What is transformer? Transformer is an electrical equipment that work on the basis of electromagnetic induction. And what are the functions of transformer? It have two main functions. The first one is to alter the voltage. That is, if we want to alter the voltage of the current, we can easily alter it by the use of transformer. And the other important function of it is it can render the current arc free. What does that mean? It means that the transformer help to produce such a circuit which have no earthing wire, that is the current is earth free and there are no chances of getting a shock. I will be explaining this in the few next minutes. Okay, so what is the basic construction of transformer? Transformer consists of a wire, insulated wire coil, that is black one and the blue one. What is it? It is a coil of insulated wire which is bounded over a soft iron core. These two are the soft iron core frames and insulated wire is bounded over this, and it can be bounded in two manners, that is either one above another and or on the two ends of the soft iron core or the soft iron frame, whatever word you want to use. So this is the basic design of the electrical transformer and its construction. Okay, now let's come toward the working of the transformer. In a transformer, we have two circuits, that is primary circuit or the primary coil and secondary or the secondary circuit, secondary coil or secondary circuit. Here there are three diagrams, 1, 2 and 3. Each of one have primary coil, secondary coil, primary and secondary coil. Now, I will explain you the working individually of these three transformers, okay? And the functions is also explained side by side, okay? Now, first of all, we will explain the step-up transformer. As you can see, in the step-up transformer, the number of coil in the primary coil are less than the secondary coil. It means that the primary coil have less coil while secondary have more number of coils. Okay, now when an alternating current is given to the primary coil, alternating current kya karega? It lead to the production of the varying magnetic field which will be linked with the secondary coil, and it lead to the production of induced current in the secondary coil. Okay, that's the principle of electromagnetic induction which we are using in the transformer concept. Okay, now there are three types. This is step up transformer, this is step down, and this is even ratio transformer. In the step up transformer, primary have lesser coil than the secondary coil. Secondary coils, okay? Which means the coil are secondary have more than primary coils. Okay, you can see these are much in number, these are less. Okay, now let's say we have given here voltage 100 volts and current is 2 ampere. Now what is power? P is equal to V into I, that is 100 into 2, 200 watts. Okay, now we need to understand that when the magnetic field will get linked with the secondary coil, here the voltage which will be produced in the secondary coil will be more than the primary coil. That is, let's say we have the primary coil having 100 coil and this have 200. For example, hypothetically we are taking these values. And as the coils are double, so here voltage will get double. That is, the output voltage will be 200 volts and the power output will remain same. What I said that the power output will remain same in both the circuit. That is 200 watt here and it will also be 200 watt here. So we can write power is equal to 200 watts. Now we need to find current. Current will become, current I is equal to P upon V. That is, what is P? P is 200 and V is also 200. That is 1 ampere. What you can check from this calculation is that the power output remains same, but the voltage and current are inversely proportional. In the primary coil, voltage is 100 and as our transformer is step up transformer, the voltage increases. It becomes 200 volt, while the current decreases, that is 1 ampere. So this is the step up transformer. What is this? It is step up transformer. Clear? Now in this, that is a step down. Here you can easily understand. Again, let's say voltage is 100 volts, current is again 2 ampere. What is power? Power will again come to out to be 200 watts. And here number of coil, let's we say we have taken 100 in primary, again we will take 100. And here we have less, let's take we have 50 coils, that is half. Now the voltage here will become half. Voltage is 50 volt, power is 200 because power output remains same in both the circuits. Now current I will be P upon Vs. I will be P upon V. What is P? 200, voltage is 50. That will be 4 ampere. Again you can see voltage become 100 to 50, that is voltage reduced, while current becomes 2 to 4, that is the current increases. It signifies the inverse relationship between the voltage and current. So this is our step down transformer in which voltage gets reduced. While in even ratio, there are no changes. Voltage remain same. Voltage remains same, that is whatever is in this, it will come output in the secondary coil. Okay, till now we have done what is the transformer, what is its principle, its construction, its working. In working we have done all the three types of transformer: step up, step down and the even ratio. What is this? It is even ratio transformer. Okay, now what are the functions? Functions are same as a working. First function is that it can alter the voltage. Yes, in step up you can increase the voltage, in step down you can decrease the voltage. This is the function. But the second function is very important. That is, it renders the current earth free. Now we will understand what is the meaning of this term, that the transformer renders the current earth free. Okay, see, as we know, the mains, the current which is supplied to our houses is from main supply or from dynamo, and we have two wires. What are these two wires? But one is live wire and other is neutral wire. Simple, one is live wire and other is neutral wire. Neutral wire. Okay. Now we have our any apparatus which is working on it. Let's say this is our apparatus, any machine, charger, anything. Okay. And the neutral wire is also connected to earth. That is, whenever there is an excess flow of current, it can be transferred to the earth. But the problem in this circuit is that whenever a connection is made between, that is a simultaneous connection is made between the live wire and neutral wire, we are very susceptible to have a shock, that is electric shock is received, which is very harmful for us. Now we will use this principle to reduce the effect of shock. That is, we can make connection between live wire and neutral wire and no shock will be received. Let's see how. Again, this is our live wire and this is our neutral wire, and we have connected them by a coil. What is this live wire? What is this neutral wire? Again, it is connected to earth. Simple. Now we will consider this as primary coil. Okay, so in the secondary coil we connect the apparatus. Now this will become secondary coil. Now when current will be flowing from the primary coil, it will produce bearing magnetic field, which will be linked with the secondary coil, and the apparatus will receive the induced current. Now if we see that our apparatus have no connection with the earth, that is, we can even hold this wire, there will be no shock received by us. That is, it helps to render the current earth free. Okay, it helps to render the current earth free. Okay, this is the second important function of the transformer, that the current from primary coil move to the secondary coil by the means of electromagnetic induction. And since the current in the secondary coil is not linked with the earth, we are not susceptible to receive any kind of shock. Okay, so these were the main basic type of transformer that we use, but there are two more type of transformer. Let me explain you that also. The two transformers are auto transformer and variable transformer. What are that? That are auto and variable transformer. Okay, see. First of all, I will explain you variable transformer. See, this is primary coil again and this is secondary coil again. But here the thing is that the primary coil have number of tappings. Tappings means it have two or three connections. Now if we use this coil from this side, you can see that this have more coils than the secondary coil. It will act as step up, it will act as step down transformer, because here coils are much more than this one. But when we use this part or even this part, it will act as step down transformer. So we can say the variable transformer it can act as step up or step down depending upon the length of the primary coil. If the length of primary coil is more, that is, the coils will be more, it will act as step down. If length of the primary coil is less, that is, the coils are less, it will act as step up transformer. So this is our variable transformer. Apart from this, there is another type of transformer, which is auto transformer. This is a soft iron core and this is first coil. And see what I have done. We use single coil in the auto transformer. What is this? It is an auto transformer. That is, we use a single coil in it which have four connections. This one, 1, 2, let we mark A, B, C and D. These are the four connections of a single coil which is bounded on a soft iron core. What is this? It is a soft iron core. Now, if we use CD as primary coil and AB as secondary coil, you will see that CD have less turn as compared to AB. That is, the coil in AB are more, it will act as step of transformer. And when we will use AB as primary coil and CD as secondary coil, this one has more coils, this one has less. It will act as step down transformer. Then you will say, what is the difference between these two, variable and auto transformer? There is only a single difference between them. It is that here as we use the single coil, listen me carefully, it is a single coil transformer. Here it have no ability to render the current earth free. Why? Because current from the primary and the secondary coil are connected. They are not transferred from primary to secondary. That is, here it is transferred from primary to secondary by means of electromagnetic induction. But here the coil is a single coil we are using. So here we have no, that is, we have disadvantage. We have disadvantage. It does not renders current earth free. Simple. What is the disadvantage of auto transformer? You can easily say, since we are using primary or single coil, there are no two coils, that is primary and secondary, no electromagnetic induction take place, and it have no ability to render the current. So this was today's lecture, in which we studied about transformer, its basic principle along with its constructions, working and functions. Functions are to increase or decrease the voltage, that is step up and down transformer, and also there is even ratio transformer, and another heading, that is the other transformer. We have variable transformer and auto transformer. What is the difference between variable and auto transformer? It is a single difference, that is, it cannot render the current earth free, while this can render the current earth free. Both can act as primary or secondary. Why? Because they have number of tappings. Here we can change the length, and here also, if we make this primary, it will become step up, and if we make this primary, it will become step down transformer. Okay, so this was today's lecture. Thank you to one and all.